Good evening and welcome to the 2024 Co-Operators General Insurance BFBA Premier League Final Series live from the Wildy Gym. It's game two in this best of five final series between Burger King Clapham Bulls and CAM Smart Assurance City United Celtics. Celtics have a 1-0 lead after taking game one 72-65 on Saturday at the BCC Gym. Will they take a decisive 2-0 lead or will Bulls even the series at 1-1? I am Mark Seal along with Terry Innes, former national player, coach, basketball administrator, and commentator. Good evening, Terry.
Good evening, Mark. I mean, you can stop at some point, right? I mean,
like, you're wearing a lot of hats, Terry.
Yeah.
But we're expecting an exciting night of basketball.
Yes. Well, you know that Celtics took game one. No one gave Celtics a chance to get in the final. They didn't give them a chance to get in the semifinal. Playing Pilots, and then they beat Pilots, and now they are up 1-0 against the much vaunted Bulls. I remember that Bulls was here before. They have been, you know, in the final last year against the Pilots, and they were down 1-0 coming to the gym. And they usually play really well in the gym.
Well, here we're going to have, we already had the announcement of the teams. So basically, we're just waiting for the basketball to start, and I can give you the starting lineups where we have for the Celtics, 0, Theo Greenidge, number 5, Anand Joseph Thorne, number 11, Joel Hunt, number 21, Renico Brewster, and number 25, Makali Downey. For the Bulls, number 1, Raheem Gibbons, number 11, Simeon Maynard, number 23, Andrew Eiffel, number 24, Akeem Marsh, and number 28, Kemar Benn. So we're just waiting now for the jump ball. The two starting fives have been called on. The referees for tonight are Rico Watson and Jillian Martindale. And Terry, Jillian, of course, a veteran referee, and I'm glad she's back for the final.
Yes, it's good to see Jillian back refereeing. We know a lot about Jillian. Jillian actually refereed World Cup games, World Championship games. Jillian is a really experienced referee, and I'm glad to see that she's here for this game. And this will be a must-win game for Bulls, because if they are down 2-0, I think it will be all over.
It's a best of five series, and we're getting ready for the jump ball, where we have Kemar Benn jumping for the Bulls, and he wins the top quite easily, as Joel Hunt didn't even bother the jump. So Bulls with first possession. Andrew Eiffel trying to get the ball inside to Benn. It's knocked out of bounds. Ball still to the Bulls.
Yes, that is Bulls ball. Let's see what they will run. Look like a box set.
And here Raheem Gibbons, the captain, he will inbound the ball for the Bulls. He's looking for Simeon Miller, the point guard, getting it hard to come in. Andrew Eiffel has it. Over now to the big man, Akeem Marsh. First shot off, he misses it, but the rebound over to the Bulls. Gibbons, Simmons, Benn on the inside in the post. He's going to turn it, he's going to try a shot, misses, and Alvarez, and it's a rebound to the Celtics, and they're off and running.
Yes, and Celtics looking, you know, they're the up and running boys. They shoot a lot of shots.
And then Joseph Thorne now, the point guard, he's with the ball over to Hunt. Hunt swings it around. The shot is off, and the rebound is by the
Renico Brewster.
Brewster with the first 2 points for the Celtics. Actually, he also opened the scoring in game one with a 3. Andrew Eiffel now with the ball for the Bulls, one of the point guards for the Bulls. Simeon Maynard, the other point guard. He can take it to the hole. He was there, but he instead passes over to Eiffel. He's not known for a shot, but he gets this one.
Yes, that's a good shot. He had the three-point shot, but then he decided to take a step in and take the 2.
Here we have now Bulls on defense. And playing some good defense. Marsh with the interception. Marsh didn't have a good game in game one. I'm quite certain he's looking to have a very big game in game number 2.
Yes, and this is Simeon Maynard, who had a really good season.
Very good season, and there he is getting to the hole, kissing it off the glass, looking for the foul. No foul, but the Bulls now up 4-2 as we are 8:07 to go in the first quarter. And now Joseph Thorne for the Celtics. He has the ball. He's calling the play. Bulls seem to be playing some sort of zone defense. It didn't work. Joel Hunt on the inside. That's 2 for the big man for the Celtics.
That is too easy.
Way too easy. But early days yet, both teams still trying to settle. Simeon Maynard dribbling, fakes the shot, gives it up to Marsh. Marsh drives, gets it back out to Eiffel. Eiffel with the open shot. Will he take it? No, he won't. Inside to Benn. Benn will definitely push this one in. in the post. He's double teamed. Kicks it back out. Minner with the open three. Misses, but rebound to the Bulls. Andrew Eiffel pushes. He gets up, misses, but it's back to the Bulls again. Bulls out rebounding the Celtics right now. Miss shot by Ben. This time the Celtics crowd the ball. Celtics running. Anand Joseph Thorne. We have a three up. Misses everything. The ball with the Bulls. What will happen here now? One on one. Eiffel misses.
Yes.
We're really having a real hard opening here for the first 2 minutes.
Yeah, I think some nerves. Some nerves. This is a big game for both teams.
Here we have now open three for the Celtics. Another air ball. Will it be saved? Nope. And it's over to the Bulls. And Terry, I know, of course, with Nicole Brewster, he's known for the three-point shot, but he has missed two already for the night.
Yeah, I think they're a little tight. Everybody is a little tight right now. I give them a couple of minutes, and they'll loosen up. There's a really big game, and, you know, you need to win this one, especially the Bulls.
For the Bulls, indeed. Bulls now with the ball. Maynard. Seems as if they're playing a 1-2-2 zone defense. Maynard, not intimidated at all. Out to Ben. Ben will take that three. He misses. Rebounded by Brewster. And it's the Celtics now coming up. Joel Hunt. The southpaw driving to the hole. And he gets the basket and the foul. That is what he did in game one. And he's back again in game two, dominating.
Yes. I really think that the Bulls are falling asleep earlier. Joel is a left-hander. And they didn't do anything to just let him waltz the hoop and then slap him on his wrist.
And, of course, Hunt is known by the Bulls team. He played for the Cavaliers up to last year, over now to the Celtics. So he's known.
Yes, it's not like if you don't know that Joel is left-handed. But we'll see what happens. The score now is 6-4.
6-4 to the Celtics.
To the Celtics. I noticed something, though. I noticed that Charlie Vanderpool is missing from the bench.
The coach for the Celtics, he will be out for the next two games. We had an interview with CBC Sports earlier this week, and he said he will be out for games two and three. And, of course, he will be deputized by Akil Brooms. So the Celtics missing their head coach for two games. Games two and three, those are two crucial games to be missing your coach.
Yes. Well, we'll see what happens.
Well, I'm quite certain he'll be following this broadcast wherever he is. I understand he's not even in the island.
Yes, he isn't.
He's out of the island. So the Celtics now a three-point lead, 7-4, 5:58 to go in the first quarter. And that's an easy dunk there by Akeem Marsh.
Yes.
As he got behind the defense, and an easy dunk for the six-footer.
Yes. Attempt a 2-1 press. It seems that the iron was cold.
Indeed. And now we have the Celtics with a three.
Theo Greenwich.
Oh, yes. I am quite certain that the Celtics wouldn't want Theo Greenwich to get hot. He wasn't hot in game number one, and he's a guy that plays with a lot of passion.
Yes.
Lots of passion. Ball out now to the captain for the Bulls, Raheem Gibbons, and he
hits
a
three. Yes.
Okay, now we're heating up.
Yep. Okay. I think now is everybody is ready now.
Celtics now leading by one. 10-9, 5:19 to go in the first quarter. Swung over now to Greenwich. He drives. He stopped. Passes it over to the wing. Back over to Thorne. I'm surprised he didn't take the shot. He tried to get it in. Didn't do a good job at that. And we have Raheem Gibbons. He almost had a fast break. He pulled it up. And missing ball contest here now. And in the end, Maynard gets the ball. And Eiffel says, let's settle it, guys. Let's settle it. Take it easy. Raheem Gibbons, that's his range. But he misses the jumper. Rebound was going to be Ben. Ben had the rebound, but stripped, and it seems as if to come off the stomach of Ben. Ball to the Celtics.
There's a foul, I think. I think Julian Marindale is calling a foul for a push, and the ball now is with the Bulls.
Well, that has to be Julian overturning what the initial call was, because even Ben was walking, going back to play some defense, but everyone is now back to play some offense for the Bulls. A foul was called. That foul is on actually Theo Greenwich has been called for that foul. That's his first foul and the first for the Celtics. Bulls on the inside. Ben blocked once. Ben blocked a second time. Ball is loose. Ball still coming with the ball. Ben, he's going to take that three. Misses. Who will get the rebound? This time it's the Celtics, and a foul is called. That should be on Marsh. Marsh going to get the steal, but instead creating the foul on Anand Joseph Thorne.
Yes, that is a foul on Marsh. A silly foul, really. I think he should try to get back. I know that he is a main guy for the Bulls, and the Bulls bench is fairly thin.
as it has been all season. It seems that they have some guys that are not available for many games.
Yes, I think they have some issues with people working late. So it is what it is. They're playing it for the whole season.
That's right.
So let's see what happens.
They have three people on the bench. Well, the Celtics, they have six on the bench. Celtics with a full 11-man lineup. Anand Judith Thorne with the three. Misses badly. No iron whatsoever. Rebound with the Bulls. Taking it easy is Gibbons. Gibbons waiting for all of his men to get back. In the meantime, Manuel Aleng has checked in for the Bulls. He is in now for Ben is the one that has gone out. Manuel Aleng is in, and that's a turnover for the Bulls. But now we have a foul by the Celtics, and I do believe that that might be the second foul on Brewster, or is it his first? No, that's the first foul on Brewster. Actually, they're calling it. According to the scoreboard, it seems as if they're, number 21, Brewster, and that is his first foul.
Yeah, that is his first. I didn't see the foul, but Jillian was a little closer than I was.
Yes, and for all of the hats you're wearing, one is not referee.
No, none of them.
So the Bulls with the ball. Marsh was in the post calling for it. He gets it. He's double-teamed. No problems. Turnaround jumper. In and out. Rebound. The guys in orange. They're really out-rebounding the Celtics. Simeon Maynard with the ball. He surveys the defense. Decides that he can dribble. Passes it now to Manuel Aleng. He gets it into Marsh. Marsh triple team. No problem at all. Basket and a foul. Marsh big on the inside.
Yes, that, I think that is where Marsh has to make his living tonight. And don't camp outside the three-point line. He and Ben should be really trying to get the ball, you know, go on the inside and really go to work.
So Marsh now will try to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. Basket. And if he can convert the free throw... He doesn't. It's flat. And Celtics with the rebound.
This is not a good sign for the Bulls. Marsh missing free throws. Marsh don't miss free throws.
Well, as you said, it's early days yet. 3:34 to go in the first quarter. Of course, you may have been watching the NCAA finals. The men in NCAA play two halves. Here, they play international rules, four quarters.
Yes.
Joseph Thorne on the point. Passes it over to Theo Greenidge. Greenidge dribbling. Tries to penetrate. He doesn't have anything. Gives it up to Thorne. Thorne to the jumper. Once again, Thorne misses. That's the third time Thorne has had a jumper and missed everything. Bulls coming away. Maynard dribbling, surveying, passing everyone. Takes it up. He's looking for the foul. Didn't get the foul. Rebound to the Celtics as their captain is also in as well for them getting the sub. But turnover. Turnover after turnover. The teams are not yet settled, but the Bulls with the ball. Eiffel gives it up to Raheem Gibbons. Eiffel gives it up to Manuel Aleng. That's an easy two. You will not get a two easier than that. He'll be quite happy with that one. Manuel Aleng coming in for Ben, wearing number six. He gets his first two.
Yes, that is a good sign for the Bulls that Aleng is actually contributing on the offensive side.
Here we have now Celtics penetrating. Open jumper with Teron. He misses. Rebound by Manuel Aleng, and the Bulls are coming back. 1-on-3, but that was no problem to Simeon Maynard, but he, very uncharacteristically, he misses the left-hand layup. And now we're getting a little hot here. I like this. 2 minutes to go in the first quarter, and we're getting the players all up in each other's face. Clearly something happened that we didn't see, but clearly Manuel Aleng did not like what happened.
Aleng is one of those guys that is a very cool dude, and if he's upset, there has to be something that really upset him.
And the referee, Jillian Martindale, is calling both players together. She doesn't want any of this, so she's calling Theo Greenidge and Manuel Aleng, talking to both of them. Shake hands.
Yep, and there's a timeout.
And there's also a timeout. So just to recap, with 2:09 to go in the first quarter, Bulls leading by 3, 13-10, Terry Ennis.
Yes, it's an interesting game as yet. I still think the Celtics, they're doing their stuff. The only issue I see right now is that they're not getting into their stuff fast enough, and they're not making the extra pass. Everybody wants to build them out. I think that's where the issue coming. For the Bulls have now decided that it's inside that they will do. And they are now taking the ball to the wall. They know they don't have any protection. So Marshall has his way. But the problem that for the Bulls would be getting Marsh some time to sit.
Yes. And that is a problem when you only have three players on the bench, and two of them really are not key players.
Correct.
So really, and also the two players on the bench are not big men.
Correct.
So they really cannot, even when they come in for Ben or Marsh, that means that the Bulls, they're going small.
Yes. So what I think Ryan Leacock is doing, he will keep one of the big men on the court while giving the other big man a rest.
Okay, and we are looking to see if there are any substitutions coming in. Yes, it appears as if Joshua Gibbs is coming in for the Celtics. He's wearing number 6. He is in, and earlier I told you Teron King is also in. He had come in earlier, so that's 2 subs made by the Celtics. The Bulls, they're keeping the same 5 on the court. Yes, they are. They're keeping the same 5 on the court, while the Celtics, they've made 1 change. We're number 6, Joshua Gibbs. He's into the game.
Yeah.
Out is Renico Brewster, who has 1 foul so far, and so far, no points.
Yeah, I noticed that the Bulls have changed to 1-2-2 zone, and they're talking about keeping the ball in the middle. They're giving the issue they will have. Oh, that's a good steal.
Very good steal, and an easy fast break for the Bulls. And that is Raheem Gibbons now on the scorecard for the Bulls, the captain. Usually known for his jump shooting, but if you're going to get an easy layup, take it. Oh, take it. And Terry, I know when you used to play for Barbados, you were a shooter yourself, but I'm quite certain if you got a fast break, you know, hey, thank you very much.
Yes, I will take a fast break any day.
Any day. And that's an attempted steal by Andrew Eiffel, but it's out of bounds, and they have to look at that. Andrew Eiffel is very quick. Once you put the ball beneath your waist, he's going to go for the steal.
Yes. I noticed the 1-2 zones being employed by the Bulls. The Bulls, and they're doing a lot of pointing. So let's see what happens now.
Joseph Thorne over to the wing to King. King saves it. Over to the new guy that comes in. He misses. Oh, the 3-point shooting of the Celtics. Not really on as yet. Bulls would like this, but still they're only up by 5. So Celtics would really like that. They're only down by 5, and they're not really hitting it. Simeon Maynard will hit that jumper any day.
Yes. I know that obviously Bulls made an adjustment, and I want to see what the Celtics will do to counteract this 1-2-2.
Well, here we have now, they finally get the ball down low, and that ball is out of bounds and it's going the other way. And I know that Joel Hunt, he's not vexed at the call. He's vexed that it slipped out of his hand.
Yes, because he will be on Marsh, and he will try to get a second foul on Marsh.
Bulls with the ball. Gibbons looking to get it into Key Marsh on the inside. They are playing a 2-1-2 zone defense, Celtics are. So they're really trying to keep that ball from getting on the inside to the big man. And here we have now Eiffel trying to drive in, but the defense was not fooled. In the end, though, the Bulls did get back the ball. And Manuel Alang now with 4 points.
Yes, and that is good for the Bulls, that Alang is being involved in the offense. And here's Hunt
also
the miss.
Missing. The shooting woes continue for the Celtics. They're still cold with just 17 seconds to go in the first quarter. Well, Bulls now playing for the last shot. 13 seconds to go. Maynard waiting. 1 last shot. They're not going to take it too early. 6, 5, 4, 3. Shot off by Eiffel. Eiffel misses, and that will end it for the first quarter. The Bulls with a 9-point lead, 19-10. They will be quite happy with how the first quarter went.
Yes. In the beginning, it looks like the Celtics would have really run away with it. But I noticed the Bulls made an adjustment, a 1-2 zone, and they are trying to cover the shooters, right? And saying that you don't have anything on the inside, so we can leave the middle open. But they're really talking well on defense, because the 1-2 zone, if you don't talk, you could get a layup.
Yes.
Because you could get a ball in the middle, you will have problems. So they're really doing a good job on the defensive side of the ball. On the offensive side of the ball, though, I think they should do a little bit more getting the ball inside the Marsh. But I think what is happening is that they are trying to start Marsh at the top and then let him roll in on the inside,
mm-hmm.
instead of trying to body up everybody all the time, which is a good idea. Mm-hmm. But I just think that the guards are not as – I think Simeon and Raheem will have to play the same side as Marsh.
Right.
So that if they collapse on Marsh, that they will get the 3-point shot.
And they are collapsing on Marsh. I think the last time he got the ball inside, immediately he was triple team, not double team, triple team. And therefore, if he's going to kick it back outside, that will open up the 3-point shot for Simeon to get. Because, you know, Simeon can shoot. Raheem Gibbons is also a shooter.
Yeah.
He's not shooting like he did 3 or 4 years ago, but he's still someone that you have to pay some attention to.
Yes. Bulls has been very, let me say, this is the on Buzz light. They usually have one big man enough guards. They actually have two big men now. So I think the problem with Bulls right now is trying to transition into these two big men. But I think once they could get the ball, keep the ball rolling, keep the ball inside, I think it would be a very long night for the Celtics. Because the Celtics have some big men, but they are not aggressive big men.
Yes.
Right? So Bulls will be able to manhandle those big men inside.
I think the word I would use, they're offensive big men, but they're definitely not defensive big men.
Yes.
I don't think they have the big men to hold Marsh at all.
No. Actually, there aren't many people in Barbados can hold Marsh, to be honest with you. But I think Bulls have to be smart. If Bulls play this game smart, they should win this game.
And now we're about to restart the second quarter. Bulls leading 19-10. That noise they're hearing in the background is all part of the officiating system here, where they try to get the attention of the referees, etc. So different things that they do to help out with the refereeing. Right now, we can tell you that the scoreboard is down. So we will still accommodate what the game started. I think the game will wait for the scoreboard to come back up. And here it is now. Yes, it's coming back up. So the scoreboard is back up. On the Celtics will have the ball. Inbounding the ball for the Celtics will be Joshua Gibbs.
Yes.
And then Joseph Thorne gets it in now to the middle. Out now to Greenwich. Greenwich will take that shot. Some rotation on the ball, but it hits the back rim and it's back out. Joel Hunt with the ball. Greenwich gets it again. He'll try again. This time, in and out. Rebounded by Marsh. Raheem Gibbs now on the point for the Bulls. He's thinking it easy. Over the timeline. Marsh. Pick and roll, maybe. He rolls in. But Ben is back into the game for the Bulls. So
yes,
the Twin Towers are back for the Bulls.
Yep.
And it works off.
Yep. The player is smart. I noticed they're not playing as fast as they usually do. Right?
And here we have now Bulls with a turnover.
Yes.
Where that was a comical one where Tyron King, he passed the ball back where he thought his teammate would have been cut in, but no one was there, and it ended up being a 2 easy points for the Bulls.
Yes.
The Bulls with another steal now. Raheem Gibbs gets the ball, gives it up now to Manuel Aleng. Aleng finds Ben. Ben didn't take the 3-point shot. As we see Simeon Maynard, he is on the bench. Yes, Maynard is on the bench. So Andrew Eiffel will not be at the point. Ben, he got the ball. I thought he would have taken it in, but he tried to get it into Ben and loses the ball.
Yes. And this is Joe Thorne with the basketball for the City United Celtics.
Yes.
Over to Gibbs.
Gibbs will take that shot.
Misses
in and out once again. The Celtics are not getting the ball to drop. Bulls now. Manuel Aleng with the ball. He's not really a point guard, but he's not being pressured, so he takes it over the timeline. Aleng looking for the player to develop. Gibbs. Andrew Eiffel. Pick and roll. No, that doesn't work out. Manuel Aleng gets it down low. Takes the shot.
Ooh.
And that's 3 for 3 for Manuel Aleng.
Yes, and Bulls must. There's a lot of praying, because Aleng is not known for. He's a really good defensive player. He's not known for his offense, but he's really doing a good job tonight.
And I know years ago when he was a schoolboy, he was a top schoolboy player on defense and on offense.
Yes.
But now he's at the Premier League level. He's known for his defense, and he's really a utility player.
Correct. And he does his bit. He goes back out.
Well, the Bulls now on with a steal for the Celtics. And King takes it coast to coast after getting the steal. So after turning over the ball several times, the Celtics finally get one going there then.
Yes, and that was a horrible turnover by the Bulls. But, you know, the Celtics are not going to go away.
And we have now Aleng going for 4 for 4, but he misses that one badly. That's only his first miss, but that is definitely not his range. Far on the outside for the three. That's not his range.
Yes, I think he just got a little, he could score a couple of baskets and think that, you know.
So he was like carried away.
Steph Curry.
Carried away.
Yeah,
yes.
He ain't carried away.
Now with the Celtics now with the ball. And now Joseph Thorne. So far, he usually looks for his shot. So far, he's only tried a couple times, but he's really just passing the ball so far. Over now to Greenwich. Greenwich looking to get it on the inside to Hunt. It's not there. Thorne dribbling. Nothing. Passes over now to King. King will take that shot. He misses. Rebounded. Woo! Fiercely rebounded there by Marsh.
Yeah.
Eiffel bringing it up for the Bulls. Bringing it over to the right. Gives it up to Gibbs. Gibbs. Very tardy pass there, but it gets in. There we have, Marsh driving to the hole. Basket and the foul. And as the youngsters say, and one.
Yes, and that was a good play by Marsh. They overplayed Marsh, and Marsh took it to the hole. He got the contact. He scored the basketball. But Marsh is a big fellow, and he can take some contact.
Was that, Terry, like 6 foot seven, 250?
Yes, about that.
About that.
And about 245 is his upper body.
Indeed. Marsh now trying to convert the old-fashioned three-point play, and he does. So that's now the Bulls really up by 15 now, 27-12. Celtics trying to stop this run by the Bulls. Over now, and we see that Brewster is back in for the Celtics. And we have now Joel Hunt coming in, trying to go to the hole. Misses. There's also in for the Celtics. Another Celtics player is also in now. Let's see. That is number 25 for the Celtics. That's Mercalli Downey is also in for the Celtics. So a timeout for the Celtics. But the coach is now running the timeouts. And he's also getting some subs coming in. So clearly the top five are not doing it for him. So he's running the subs.
Yes. I think they are not. I don't think they're making an adjustment. And they're not making an adjustment quickly. Mm-hmm. I think. It looks like there's a lot of chatter on the bench and there's no coherence.
So, Terry, if you were the coach of the Celtics, what would you be telling the players right now?
Right now, I would tell them, well, it's the only first half. Games don't finish in the first half unless he lets go, and then the game will play over. So, it would be, what I would tell them is that we can't try to get back all one time. It's still only first half. So, just take your time and work your stuff. I think what they're doing, they're hurrying the shot. Bulls have decided to wear a 1-2-2 defense, and apparently the Celtics were not ready for this 1-2-2 defense. So they're going to push out the stuff that they want to do.
And I guess on another note, that is now called good coaching, so we have to talk about Ryan Leacock making the adjustments.
Yes, he did, apparently. And let's hope that the Celtics would recognize what is happening and make their adjustments too.
This game will be over early.
Yeah, very early.
They're now down by 16, 28-12. The Bulls with the ball and with the lead. Looking now to find Marsh. Finds Marsh. Marsh did not have a big man on him. I'm surprised he didn't take it to the hole. And it ends up with the Bulls turning over the ball. Raheem Gibbons trying to find Eiffel, but too long.
Yes, I don't know why he would be looking to pass the ball over there. But he tried it. It didn't work. They're still up 16.
Thorn with the ball for the Celtics. Finally gets it on the inside, but then it's right out to the outside jumper. The three-point sharp shooter for the Celtics. But that's his third miss, and all three have been bad misses. So Brewster not having a good game so far after lighting it up in the first game for 16 points.
Yeah, but as I told you, Mark, in the pregame, you know, everybody, a lot of players look really good in gym, in BCC.
In the community college. Indeed.
Right? But it'd be a problem when again in the gym.
In the gym. And that's Eiffel with a hard, tough miss there. Ball rolled all around the rim and then rolled out. Celtics with the ball. Thorne gives it up to Brewster. He drives. That's not his player. And he tries it anywhere. Rebounded by the Bulls. Celtics still cold with 5:35 to go in the second quarter. And they still only have 12 points on the cards. Gibbons.
They've got 12, but Bulls should be at least 40.
So, therefore, both teams not really playing at their best. But the Bulls, with the miss, are still on the advantage. Here we have now Greenidge. He's yet to get hot in this series altogether. Drives, but this time he gets the referee's whistle. I'm quite certain that he may have said he should have been going to the line a few times, but he's going to the line this time.
Yes. We all know Theo. Theo feels that he should be at the line every day, right? But this time I think he got a foul, and he was very aggressive. He didn't settle for the three-point shot. So, yes, he's now at the line. And it is good to have a break in play so that, you know, they can regroup.
And coming in now for the Celtics is Jared Allen. He's coming in for the Celtics. Is that Jared Allen? Yes, it is. He's coming in for the Celtics. Also, we see that Simeon Maynard is also back in for the Bulls. And on the bench is Andrew Eiffel. So, free throws coming for Theo Greenidge. He hits the first.
Yeah, he's a very good free throw shooter, and also he gets a lot of free throws.
Yes, he takes the ball to the hole. He's very good at taking it to the hole. Theo Greenidge in the first game, as far as the free throws are concerned, as you said, he always has good free throw shooting. He actually didn't get to the line in the first game. In the first game, he had no free throws. So that is something that the Bulls would have been happy about, despite the loss.
Yes.
Turnover now for the Bulls for the Celtics. And we have Joel Hunt with the ball. gives it up to Greenidge. Greenidge, outside of the range, passes over to the new guy who has just come in. Swing it over the outside to the three-point shooter, the marksman. Will that one drop? In and out. And the Bulls with the rebound. Raheem Gibbons dribbling, taking his time. He's now over the timeline. 5 seconds to get over the halfway line. He does it quite easily. Marsh with that flat three-pointer, but that's how he shoots them.
Yes, and he gets three. I will not be writing the home mother about that one, but it is 3 points to the Bulls, and that puts them up by 17.
Marsh now into double figures with 10 points and another turnover by the Celtics. This is not looking good. 31-14, Bulls leading. They're down by one game in the series, but they're looking quite good to even up the series. Simeon Maynard with the ball. Takes it over to the right side. Dribbles, looking to get Marsh. Marsh immediately double-teamed. It swung over to Manuel Alang. He gives it up to the other big man, Ben. Kicks it out. Back to Maynard. Maynard drives. Pulls up for the 12-foot jumper. In and out. Rebounded by the Celtics.
Yes, and that's Hunt. And he's over to Downey. And Downey pulls three. And he misses.
But that's rebounded. Oh, and steal there by Raheem Gibbons. Gibbons turning up tonight. He usually does play some good defense as well. And he's playing it tonight. Bulls playing a lift. The season is depending on it. As we said, if they lose game two in the best of five, that could be good night nurse. But they're playing quite well tonight.
Yes.
Inside now to Ben. Ben, yes. Inside. That's where the big man should be. Basket and the foul. The Bulls big men are dominating.
Yes, and this is how the Bulls should play every night.
And Ben,
because you know that Celtics is really soft on the inside. They have good players. I'm not saying they don't have good players on the inside.
Call it as you see it, Terry Cole.
Yeah, but
they have big offensive players.
Yes. But you see Ben and Marsh, those are half-full. Those guys are half-full, you know, in this game.
Ben completes the three-point player, basket, and the free throw. And the Bulls now are up by 20, 34-14. Celtics, though, with 3:17 to go in the half, will try to reduce some of that deficit going into the break. So we have now Brewster with the ball, gives it up to Theo Greenidge. Greenidge, well outside the three-point line. He wouldn't take it from there, would he? He drives. He's going to get an easy layup this time. Wells is in. Good play by the Celtics.
Yes. Some patience. And it worked. I think they're going to do a lot more of that. And they're also going to play some D. They need to keep Ben out of the paint.
Well, Ben trying to go one-on-one in the post. Tried a nice finger roll, but nothing. And we get that ball out of there where we had Greenidge going for the layup. He thought he was past the big man, but the 6'7" Marsh took it and swiped it almost into the seats. Get that weak stuff out of there.
Yes, and he made sure he told him that it was weak.
And what I realized, you know, Terry, is that these players, they play with each other when they're scrimmaging on Sundays and all that sort of thing. They know each other. And although he told him, you know, get that out of there, you saw that both of them did that, shared a smile.
Yes. But, you know, the Premier League group is a small group. It's 8 teams, right? And everybody knows everybody. It's unfortunate that the rise of Celtics make the decline of other teams. But it is what it is. Those other teams have to go about, regroup, and try to make the Premier League, the BBL Premier League, a little better next year.
Well, actually, I think it was very good by the Celtics to get those players that they got. They got quite a few players, like I said, the big ticket. If you want to say the big ticket swap in the offseason was definitely Joel Hunt from the Cavaliers.
Yeah, well, the Celtics had a nice buzz around basketball. Everybody was talking about the players that left, the players that are going over, the assistant national coach became the coach. I mean, there was a nice buzz around basketball for the preseason. And I don't think in Van der Poel's wildest dream that he would expect that in his first season with the Celtics that they would be in the finals playing against Bulls.
And let's put that into perspective. Coming into the playoffs, the Celtics were the number 4 seeds. The Bulls were the number 3 seeds. And the 3 and 4 seeds are here in the finals.
Yes.
Celtics now with the ball. Brewster looking to find someone. He does find someone. Yes, he does. Downey has the ball. Gives it up now to the top where we have Ali with the jumper. He misses. Rebounded yet again by the Bulls. And we have Rock now in for the first time for the Bulls. The Bulls now being able to rest some of their key players. Raheem Gibbons is being rested. Also, Manuel Alang is still on the bench as well. Simeon Maynard with the jumper. He misses. Will it be corralled by the Bulls? Nope. Ball goes to the Celtics, where we have Theo Greenidge. Will he try to lay up again in front Marsh? Yes, he does. But this time he gets the foul, and the referee, Jillian Maynard, calls the foul.
Yes, Jillian saw something, and she was able to call the foul. And Theo goes back to the line. And here comes Marsh is out now, and he's being replaced by that's Andrew Eiffel.
Andrew Eiffel is going in, and let's see when the scoreboard is updated. How many fouls? I think that's two. If we can go from our recollection, I think that's number two on Akeem Marsh. But the way how they're going, 34-16, I think he can sit out for the rest of the quarter.
Yes, he can. And a rare miss
by Theo Greenidge at the line. Like I said, he didn't get to go to the line at all in the first game. Here he is now, taking the ball to the hole. Clearly that was an adjustment that they would have made to get him to the free throw line. He got there, but he missed the first one. Will he miss the second? No, he won't. Wouldn't make that mistake twice. So the Celtics now up to 17, but they're still down by 17, 34-17. Here we have now Andrew Eiffel back in the game at the point for the Bulls. Passes over to Rock. Rock looking for Ben. He had Ben, but didn't give it to him. Rock still dribbling. Trying to get it in now to Eiffel on the baseline. Intercepted, but also in for the Bulls, that's number six. That would be Daniel Gibbs.
Yes, Gibbs. Another Gibbs.
That's Daniel Gibbs.
Yes.
Playing for the team in Ariana.
Oh, this is steal by Rock.
Rock has the steal, and he has 4-on-1. He finds Ben. Rock back with the ball. Eiffel setting up the player. Drives. He'll dish it. No, he doesn't because he's horse-colored. Oh, that was a tough one going in, but this is playoff basketball. Can't go through there and don't expect to get hit.
Yes, and you're saying, okay, we'll earn your 2 points at the line.
At the line, you're not going to get any finger rolls in the final. So go to the line, earn it. But, of course, Eiffel, you know, he's known for his defense, also being a good point guard. Let's see what he can do from the free throw line.
He misses
that one. And if we can just look back at the first game, as far as free throws are concerned, Eiffel, 50%. He got to the line twice, scored one.
Okay.
So, yeah, right now, let's see if he can make that 50% here in game number two. He missed the first one. 50% in the second game.
Yeah, so, well, it is. Obviously, his average. His average is correct.
He's made his average.
Yes.
And we have a sub coming in. Joel Hunt is going out.
And here comes Joseph Thorne.
And that's a point guard for the one of the big men for the Celtics, so they're going small. Let's see how that works out for the Celtics. Alleen passes over now to Greenidge. Greenidge finds Thorne. Thorne can't get around this 1-2-2 defense, but Greenidge will take a three. He misses, and the ball is going to be corralled by the Celtics. The Celtics with a rare offensive rebound. Here we have now, will they get something going on offense with 54 seconds to go in the half? Thorne takes another jumper, misses once again. Thorne is yet to score in this game. Booster also misses. And we have the Bulls trying to go some offense, but sloppy handling of the ball. He misses. And sloppy on the other end. Bulls now with the ball. With 32 seconds to go in the first half. Let's see if they can hold it. They only have 15 seconds on the shot clock, so clearly not the final shot of the half.
They just want to make sure that they keep it down and they'll travel. Turnover.
Yeah. Took a step before he dribbled.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, took a step before he dribbled. That's a turnover there by Andrew Eiffel. Of course, if the name Andrew Eiffel sounds familiar to you guys who used to go to the YMCA, he's the son of former national player Andrew Eiffel Sr.
Yes. And that is Rock with a steal.
Taking it to the hole. Yeah. Getting the foul and going to the free throw line.
Yeah.
I haven't seen this fire in Rock so far for the season as well.
Well, you know, playing time in a final, right? If you want more playing time, go out there and play really hard. And give your – Raheem is on the bench, and so is Akeem Marsh. So he has to do what he can do, which is really play some hard D.
Rock also has some – he has some family connections also with former national teams.
Yeah, oh, yeah. His uncle is Barry Rock. His dad is Junior Rock.
There you go. Two former nationals, senior and junior nationals. Barry Rock actually was a former head coach of the Bulls as well.
Yes. And he missed both?
He missed both free throws. And the ball goes back to the Bulls.
Yeah, Tampa Bay do nothing wrong in the first half.
But I think they're a little bit more aggressive than Celtics right now.
Indeed. 9 seconds to go in the first half. The Bulls up by 20, 37-17. With 9 seconds to go, clearly they'll look to take the final shot of the half. Eiffel gets it into Ben. Ben should have done a lot better than that. But I think that ball should be going to the Bulls. Yeah,
yes,
I think
so. 6.4 to go.
Yep.
Ben should have actually scored that. But, you know, there's something that big men should be doing. Be able to shoot the ball without bringing it down. And obviously he doesn't do that.
Well, yeah, and he was uncontested. But at any rate, let's go. Just 2-1. And do you imagine
that is
with 0.7 of a second on the clock, Rock is fouled and he scores and will go to the line to complete the three-point play.
Yes, and I think it is going to be a very long night for the Celtics. Very, very long.
Or short.
Well, I'm saying long because they have to go another half.
Oh, yeah. But definitely, clearly we're not. I don't think we're going to get a lot of strategy timeouts and all that in this one. And Rock misses again from the free throw line. Simeon Maynard had the opportunity maybe to get a four-point play, but he misses the rebound, put it back. And that's it for the first half. The Bulls leading by 22 points, 39-17. Really and truly, I don't know how the Bulls will lose this one from here, but this is definitely playoff basketball, so you definitely should not count out the Celtics.
I just think the Celtics need to just regroup. I think right now they're missing their coach, and they're playing like they're missing the coach. They needed some strong instructions, and I don't know. I can't say anything bad about the assistant coach because they don't know anything about him.
Akil Bones.
But what I can tell you is that I know that if Charles Vanderpool was here, I don't think they'd be down by 22.
Of course, you must give some credit to the coaching. Actually, nowadays, you always hear about if a team has been out-coached. Once upon a time, you always hear about if the team has been outplayed. But now there's actually that stat of if you have been out-coached.
Yes. And I think for right now, Ryan Leacock is looking like Phil Jackson.
And that is also a thing of Phil Jackson, the coach of the Chicago Bulls, who would have won six titles. And just to look at the scorecard, look at going into the half, leading the scoring for the Bulls, we have Akeem Marsh with 10 points, shooting 4 of 6. So he's having a good night so far. Raheem Gibbons, he has 7 points. Simeon Maynard, 4. Andrew Eiffel, 3. And Kemar Ben, he has 5. Coming off of the bench, Manuel Aleng, he has 6. Gibbs, he has 2. Rock, he has 2 as well for their 39. Looking at the Celtics United, no one is in double figures right now, but Theo Greenidge, he has 8. 2 of 7, though, of shooting. I know the percentage for the Celtics is not going to be good reading whatsoever. Actually, the team percentage for the Celtics is 20%. Not good at all. Adnan Jonathan, as I said, no points, 0 for 3 shooting. Joel Hunt, he has 5. Brewster has 2. Downey, he's yet to score as well. King has 2, and no one else has scored for the Celtics. It's not a very pleasant reading scorecard for the Celtics.
Yes, it isn't, and I think they should just try to regroup, try not to get back all in one go. And the third quarter will be interesting. Try to get it to 10 by the fourth quarter. And once you get the cat among the pigeons, anything happen.
Now, Terry, I have to take up on that one because, you know, I always listen to the English. And you said it is going to be a tight third quarter. So clearly you're expecting the Celtics to bounce back.
Yes. I don't think the Celtics will want to roll over and play a date. So we'll see what they do.
Excellent. And as far as the Bulls, you know, because obviously we're not biased on this commentary table. So as far as the Bulls are concerned, what would you be telling the Bulls who are now up by 22 points? What would you tell the Bulls?
I would tell them keep going. They're going to need to keep going and keep getting the ball on the inside to Marsh and Bing. And this game should be over by midway through third quarter.
So let's get this straight. If you are talking to the Celtics, you're telling them we're carrying this into the fourth. But if you're talking to the Bulls, oh, this is over, we'll be resting our big men.
Yes.
Getting ready for
Thursday.
Yeah,
for Thursday night.
And let us just make sure we will be online and on TV8 on Thursday for Game 3. No matter the result, we'll be here for Game 3.
Yes.
So, of course, now we have our halftime show where we have just recapped
the first half of this game. But also, Terry, I know you have a special guest for our halftime show.
Yes, and this is Alan Pender. He is the Belgian scout, and he'll be up talking about the NBA. And you know, tonight is not only a big night for the Barbers basketball, but also the NBA.
Indeed. The NBA, they are having the play-in. Once upon a time, you'll be talking about the playoffs. The playoffs will start, but we are having the play-in, and they're having some big teams actually in the play-in. We have the Warriors playing tonight, and the Lakers, they're also playing tonight. But of course, Terry, I'll hand you over to your halftime guest, or you can talk some NBA basketball.
Yes, and with me is Alan Pender. We call him the Belgian Scout. He is known for his NBA prowess. So, Alan, right now, the NBA, the play-in is happening. In the West, it is Warriors versus Kings. Yes. A 46 win team will be going home shortly.
Yes.
So, that game will be late, so we will see how that game goes. And then the Lakers are against Pelicans.
Yes.
So, what do you think about that?
Well, they did a really good job against the Pelicans a few days ago. So I think the Pelicans are going to come back strong with this game. And I think Lakers actually probably won't mind falling to the A spot, potentially in that last playing game, and get a matchup with them. Avoid the matchup with Denver and get a matchup instead with the OKC Thunder.
You think that they will weather the OKC City Thunder instead of
Denver Nuggets.
Yeah. I would take that. As a Lakers fan, I would take that.
I don't think they'll intentionally lose, but I don't think they'll mind necessarily if this game doesn't work out tonight.
Yeah, okay. And then the other side is Warriors and Kings.
Yes.
I really feel the Warriors going home. I don't know what you think.
Well, the Kings have not been playing well recently. They've really been struggling. They have some injury issues, so I think that the Warriors are probably going to come out on top in this one.
Oh, okay.
I don't think the Warriors are going to make the A spot in the end, but I think they'll probably survive this first game.
Okay, so you're saying that is the West. What about the East?
In the East, well, I think the Bucks. Well, in the playing game you're talking
about.
Yeah,
in the playing games.
Well, in the playing game, I think that the Heat are probably going to end up with that A spot in the East, because they have to play. They're going to play the 76ers in the first game.
Oh,
I think the Sixers will probably win that game and claim the seventh spot.
Yes.
And I think they'll then be the Bulls versus the Heat for that last spot. I think the Heat will most likely prevail in that game.
Do you think that Celtics will want to play the Heat in the first round?
Well, traditionally no, but I think this iteration of the Heat has been struggling. I know people lose you off the Heat every year, and the Heat come back to bite them. But I think this year, this might be the small sum potentially.
Yeah, well, I really feel I don't ever conquer the Heat. There's always look like a garbage team until playoff time.
True.
Right, and then our playoff time, there's somehow raise the game to another level. So if I'm number one, I would not want to see the Heat. But, true. I mean, hey.
The Celtics have been extremely good this season. They've been having an excellent season, plus minus. They're having one of the best seasons for sure this year. So I think that they won't have any problem with the Heat this year. I would say as much as Roy Sweetland.
Okay. So tell me. Then you get to who you think will get out of the West?
The West? Yeah, I think Denver is probably the favorite for the West, most likely.
You still feel Denver is the favorite for the West?
I still think the Denver should come out of the West.
I feel so too. As a Laker fan, I still feel so.
Yes, agreed.
Yeah. And in the East, I really feel that Boston has been the best basketball team in the actual NBA this season.
Yes. Yeah, I think Boston should mostly come out in the East as well. The problem with the East is that a lot of top teams have injuries. The same Bucks with Giannis having an injury right now. Embiid's come back from his injury. I think if he comes back really strong, the Sixers may have a chance. But without home court advantage, it's going to be tough for them. But yeah, the Celtics probably will come out of the East.
Yeah, so then it'll be Celtics versus Nuggets.
Yep. That's going to be a tough one to call.
Well, Celtics versus Nuggets, yeah.
Yes.
I don't know. I feel that the Nuggets, somehow they raise the level of the game. Especially Murray, he really plays at a high level when it comes to playoff time. But I don't know if I could bet against the Celtics, really.
Yeah, I mean, the Nuggets are one of the best clutch teams in the NBA. They've proven that over the year. But what you're saying about the Celtics already have it all put together this year. They've gone through their growing pains. They've had a lot of tough losses in the playoffs over the years. Eventually, I think this is going to be the year that they come through.
Yeah, I would like this to be the year for them as well.
Yeah, everything's lined up really well for them.
Yes, and this is the Bears scout. This is Alan Pinder. And for right now, as we say, the court is adjourned.
And we're back here with the second half of the game number 2 in the co-operators General Insurance BABA Premier League Final Series. I am Mark C with Terry Ennis. The Bulls are leading 39-17, but as you were saying, Terry, at the halftime, another half to go, but it doesn't start good for the Celtics because that's Gibbons with a 3.
Yes, and a well-executed basketball player. The ball went around the court and then saw Raheem Gibbons by himself. And he took that shot. And again, the Bulls are in the 1-2, and a lot. If you notice, you're seeing a lot of talking.
And once again, another turnover by the Celtics. The Bulls now will try to capitalize on it. And we have Simeon Maynard taking it easy, bringing it down, waiting for Marsh's big man to get it over the halfway line. He pulls up for that 12-foot jumper. He will nail that 90% of the time. Simeon Maynard with another 2.
Yes. Simeon is, for the entire season, has been like the top point guard in the island. He and Darren has been the top point guards, and he's showing why.
Yes, I hear we have now Joel Hando doing what he knows he can do, what he didn't do in the first half, taking it strong, the southpaw, going with the left hand, getting the basket and the foul.
Yes, and Joel, I think he's had enough of this. He thinks now it's time now for him to show up.
And actually, he needs to show up. He only had 5 points in the first half, but he's now up to 7. And he can, if he mailed this, he can actually up now to 8. But he misses, but he gets his own rebound. Takes it strong, and that's Marsh with the block. And I thought the ball actually came off of Hunt, but obviously, Jillian Martindale, she is in the better position. And that's ball now staying with the Celtics.
Yes, that is, and to inbound the ball would be Renicole Brewster. And he is from the City United Celtics.
Yes,
and here we go.
Brewster now, he didn't have a good first half at all, but you see what he can do in the second half. Thorne didn't have a good first half either, 0-for-3 shooting. Now gives it up to Greenwich. Greenwich was their top scorer in the first half, but that's an air ball. So if their top scorer is shooting an air ball, it might be a very, very long night for the Celtics. But here they are now on defense. It has to start here somewhere, offense or defense. And the defense almost came up with the steal, but through the hands of the player, straight into Marsh, and that's 2 easy points for Marsh.
Yeah, probably the easiest points he will get for the evening.
And here we have now Brewster into Hunt. Hunt, a one-man show, but he gets the foul. Coach Rico Watts, referee Rico Watson calls the foul. It's not a shooting foul, so the ball will be taken from the baseline.
Yes, that is a foul on Gibbons, who seemed not to. I hope he does not get his the traits from his dad, Who never fought a person in his life?
That's Barry. Raheem Gibbons, that's the son of Barry Rock, former national player, played for the Bulls, also played for the Senators. Barry Rock played for the Senators when you were playing for Springfield.
Yes.
Indeed. There you go.
It was a lot of nice duels with the Barry Rock. It was a very good shooter.
Very good, excellent shooter. Actually, yes. You yourself, Elk, I know you were a very good shooter. Actually, the team that year that you made the national team, and unfortunately you had that injury with your eye, you were a lights out man.
Yeah, well, you know what? They say every dog has his day. I had my day.
You had your year.
Yeah.
Celtics now with the ball, and Hunt really coming to play now in the second half. Maybe Joel Hunt can be the savior for the Celtics. It's still a long way to go. They're down 46-21, and the Bulls with the ball. Simeon Maynard taking the top slowly, letting some time run off the clock. Dribbling, fancy, he has handles. Maynard, ball stolen by Hunt, comes up with a steal. And now the ball out of bounds, and it will stay with the Celtics. But Hunt with two quick baskets and a steal.
Yes, and I think Maynard is playing around with the basketball too much. I think he should just pass the ball, do your thing, and get into your stuff a little quicker.
Hunt, obviously given permission to take the ball to the hole. This time he loses it, but he has some teammates there playing with him.
That is Downey.
Downey getting the offensive rebound and putting it back up strong, telling us that, hey, I'm a big man too. So let's see if he can play some big man defense, because not only they cannot trade buckets with the Bulls.
Yeah, because Bulls is up by 20 yep. plus.
Cannot trade baskets. And we have Maynard now trying the fancy handles and once again loses it. Maybe needs to hear you, Terry, and try not to be so fancy.
Yep.
And it goes now to Greenwich, who gets the easy two. So Maynard definitely has to take care of the rock.
Yes, this is three turnovers.
And this time he gets the foul, though.
Yes, a foul on Brewster.
That's on Brewster, I think. And, of course, he I don't know if it's a bit of acting, but for the time Maynard was touched, you know, he let the head go back.
Yeah.
I made sure that the referee saw, hey, I got touched.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know, this is everybody watching the NBA, so we got some traits from them as well.
Hey, that's not a problem. And he got the foul.
Yes.
So no problem at all. So we have a timeout with 6:51 to go in the third quarter. The Bulls are leading by 21. They're leading 46-25. And we don't know how the Celtics will come back from this one, but there's still hope. But looking at the scorecard, we have Akeem Marsh with 12, Raheem Gibbons with 10. Those are the game's two high scorers. And Joel Hunt, who has now come to the party, 4 of 8 field goals, but he still only has 9.
Yes, I think they've decided that they will try to go inside, put some pressure on the Bulls on the inside in that 1-2. Nothing is wrong with that, but it's just got to be consistent. Mm-hmm. And I think the issue for the Celtics is to be consistent and be patient, because you can't get the ball inside after one pass. So you have to be patient and get the ball around. And the 1-2 zone is soft in the middle. So they're doing the right things. Let's see if it pays off.
So the 1-2 zone, we'll get back to you on that one, if that's the best zone to be implemented. But we'll get back to that as we have action again in the third quarter. Simeon Maynard gives the ball to Akeem Marsh at the top. He finds Gibbons, who is back in off the bench for the Bulls. Maynard drives, gives it down low to Manuel Alain. He misses, but Akeem Marsh is there for the putback, and Marsh is the big man inside. He can't be stopped tonight.
Yeah, I think Marsh has decided that this is his game, and he will try to see if he can even up this score.
Brewster now with the ball for the Celtics. He gives it up to Anand Joseph Thorne. Thorne, the baseline jumper. That's now 4 attempts at jumpers for Thorne. He has missed all 4. Not his night at all. Maynard with the ball for the Bulls. He gives it up quickly to Raheem Gibbons. Gibbons tries to drive. Well defended, so he passes it back out. Marsh at the top, looking for something. He finds Andrew Eiffel. Eiffel looking now for someone on the inside. He has no one. He takes the jumper. He misses. That's not his shot, but he wasn't marked, so he took it.
Yeah, it wasn't a bad shot. It just needed a little air. Push it a little bit more. And that is Hunt down the middle.
And that is Hunt. That is what he did in the first game. And that's what he didn't do in the first half of the second game. But clearly, they talked about it. That's a plan. And he now has 11 on the night. Manuel Alang with the ball. Inside now to Marsh. Well, attempted to get inside to Marsh. But triple teamed. And they come up with the steal, the Celtics do. and they're bringing it up. Thorne gives it up now to Hunt. Hunt, marked by Ifill. He gives it back to Thorne. Thorne, looking for someone, finds no one. Keeps the dribble. Gives it a note to Brewster. That's his spot. Will he hit it? No, he doesn't. Brewster is also yet to score, but that is now for the Celtics. That's a score now for number 23. That's Codrington? No, actually, yeah. That's number 25. 35. That is Downey.
Downey.
That's yes. Downey. Missed the number there. That's Downey now with that putback. And that's 4 points now for Downey off the bench. The Bulls, Raheem Gibbons, that's his place. But that one is in and out and rebounded by Joel Hunt. And that's a foul by Andrew Ife. He doesn't even wait to contest it with Jillian Martindale, the referee. He knows that was the foul.
Yes, and as you notice, the Celtics are really taking the time and grinding this one out. And they're getting, I think the Bulls will have to make another adjustment, because they're actually getting the ball in the middle fairly easy now.
Now, the Celtics, with the ball, trying to cut further into this deficit. They find Hunt down low, but he's stripped, and the ball stays though with the Celtics. But Hunt now really getting the ball easily on the inside, but just as they do with Marsh, I find as he gets the ball on the inside, he's doubled or triple teamed.
Yes, and they're daring the jump shooters to beat them. And as yet, the jump shots are not dropping, so.
No, they're not. Yep. So they have to get it into Hunt. And we also now have the captain of the Celtics. He's back in. That's King. King is also, he also fancies himself as a jump shooter. Right now, he's unmarked, so he'll take this one. King with the shot. He misses. Rebounded by Marsh, who is immediately, as he gets the ball beneath his waist, the players jump on him to try to steal. They did steal it, but it's a jump ball. And the possession arrow is with the Bulls. So it will stay with the Bulls.
Yes, and is with the Bulls or with the Celtics?
Well, let's see. Yes, it seems as it's with the Celtics. I thought the possession arrow was with the Bulls. And just for those of you who may not have been following the basketball for a few years now, once upon a time when there was a jump ball, they would go and have a literal jump ball. But now we have the possession arrow.
Yes, and that has been so for a little bit. You only have one jump ball per game, which is a startup game. After that, it is alternate possessions.
Alternate possessions. So if the Celtics now have the ball, it means the next time there's a jump ball, the Bulls will have the ball. So yeah. As Terry was saying, it stays with the Celtics. Brewster will pass the ball from the baseline. He finds King. King over to Greenidge. Greenidge looking to get Hunt on the inside. He's immediately triple team. Finds Brewster, and they finally find Hunt. Hunt stops and pops. Hunt definitely now is ready to play.
Yes, I think they've decided that Hunt is the man to get them out of this hole. So they're feeding the basketball.
Hunt,
let's see what our Bulls do.
Hunt with 13 points. King now with the steal. What will he do? He gets the finger roll and he misses. And he's fouled though by Andrew Ifill. I thought Ifill may have gotten all ball on that one, but clearly maybe got some of the wrist or the forearm. But the ball will be going for the Celtics. I think it will be going to the free throw line for King. But some sloppy passing there by the Bulls.
Yes, and also I thought Ifill got away with a foul in the first time. So again, he fouled the second time. It may have been a makeup
foul.
Yes.
And here we have now King on the line, and he scores the first. And Terry, I'll get you quickly on this one. What do you think about a three referee rotation? I know we have tried it years ago, and I think we usually just use the two referee rotation. Do you think a three man rotation for the referees might see more calls?
Yes, they would. Once you do it properly, because you don't want to see three referees looking at the same player. The idea is to have three referees covering the whole court. And they brought three referees because of how big the players are now nowadays and how quick they are.
And that's King missing, scored the first free throw, missed the second. Bulls now with the ball. Gibbons looking for someone on the inside. It was Marsh, couldn't get it to Marsh. Simeon Maynard with the handles. I think he could just keep it simple, but he tries to make it hard, but he did get back the ball. Andrew Ifill now drives. Gives it down low to Manuel Alang. He misses, but the ball will stay with the ball, saved by Alang. But we have a whistle, and we have
that is shot clock violation.
Shot clock violation.
The ball didn't hit the ring.
Yes, that's correct. The ball must hit the ring, even if it hit the backboard, but it must hit the ring in order for it not to be a shot clock violation. You have 24 seconds on the shot clock. Those seconds were up. You must hit the ring. Didn't hit the ring. Ball to the Celtics.
Yeah, How long Bulls have been at 48?
Quite a bit now. So that is why they're actually, Celtics are cutting into this deficit. They're now down by only 16. So we can actually have a game in the fourth quarter as Hunt now on the inside once again and scores once again. Hunt now with 15 points, with 11 of them coming in the second half.
Yes. And now it is crunch time for the Bulls.
Yeah, that's.
Let's see what happens.
Andrew Eiffel, the Bulls have not scored for quite a bit. And we have Andrew Eiffel trying to score. He has not scored in a bit. And once again, he loses it. Ball on the ground. Jump ball now. And the ball will this time be going to the Bulls.
Yes.
And that is a turnover that the Celtics did not want to give.
Actually, that could be a turning point because they had an easy two.
Easy two. And of course, you now see the towel is on the court. Just to let you know, yeah, we don't have any mop boys here. So obviously the players will have to mop up any moisture, any perspiration that might be on the wooden floor because it could get very slippery.
Yes, it can. I think right now the Bulls look kind of ragged. I think that the Celtics made the adjustments that they wanted to, and now the Bulls having some problems.
Akeem Marsh being double teamed in the post. They're trying to get it to him. They can't get it to him. So therefore, they take the outside jumper, and Gibbons breaks that 48 lock. Bulls finally getting the half century thanks to Gibbons.
Yes, and that's the first two in 4 minutes.
4 minutes or so, and there's only 2:23 left to go in the half. And that's now King with one of his bullet passes down low, but he didn't find his intended target of Greenwich, and it's a turnover. Bulls with the ball.
Yes, there's a couple of things that you should try not to do, especially when you're behind, and it's turn over the ball. I usually tell my guys I rather shoot way than a turnover, because a pass way will never get to the hoop.
So
shoot it away. If you shoot and miss, you know, I don't mind, but if you pass away the basketball, we don't have a attempt.
No chance. And we have now on Akeem Marsh and King really fighting there in the post. Clearly, King has been sent in. Do not let Marsh get the ball in the post. But he gets the ball in the post and dunks it on King's head.
Yes, and says something to him too.
Yes, of course, these guys, you know, they let you know, hey, you really can't mark me.
That is a travel.
But that's a travel. Thorne not having a good game at all in this second game. He has no points, and he's now turned over the ball, 0-for-4 shooting. And turnovers, that is now turnover number 6 for Thorne.
Ooh. And remember I told you that jump ball was a turning point? You noticed they don't score. They haven't scored since that jump ball.
They're making you into a profit.
Yeah. I hope not.
Gibbons with the ball. Gives it to Emmanuel Alain. He will take the shot. That's not really a shot, but it drops.
Yes. Well, that's his shot.
And Emmanuel Alain now, he is looking pretty good. He has really come on the offense for this game. But a foul now on the Bulls. I think Gibbons is saying, me? Not on you. They actually call it on Marsh. So actually, Gibbons was right. It's not you. It's Marsh.
Yeah. So it's been interesting turn of events. You had a jump ball, and then there were 6 straight points from the Bulls and 3 straight turnovers from the Celtics.
Yes, and they're now back down by 20.
Yep.
54-34, but it's now back down to 19 as Joel Hunt, that man again, he's at the line, and he's really bringing them back in. He now has 16 points, and he only had 4 in the first half.
Yes, and what they're doing is what they should have done from the beginning, which is get the ball on the inside and let him go to work.
This one hits the front of the ring, and it still scores. Alain trying to get the rebound, but no, it was already through the cylinder. So the ball given as 1 point, and now the Bulls on offense. Simeon Maynard, again, not playing like we know he can. But still, his team is up. They find Marsh in the post. Marsh, pull-up jumper, in and out. Flat, no air, hit the ring and was out. Now Andrew Eiffel with the steal for the Bulls. Not good for the Celtics. The Bulls with another steal. As you can hear the applause from the bench. Maynard driving. Will he get the pull-up jumper? Misses. Rebound by Joel Hunt. That man, Joel Hunt, once again, taking it easy. As we have under a minute to go in the third quarter. And the Bulls are up 54-35. Joseph Thorne dribbling. Gives it up to King. King over to the wing. Shot taken. Misses. And is Thorne going to get a rebound? He did, but then stripped by Eiffel, but it's out of bounds. It stays with the Celtics.
Yes, the Celtics are really playing a little slow to me. I think they really should, you know, add some aggression to where they're doing.
Some urgency.
Yes, good word.
Joseph Anand Thorne with the ball. Gives it up to Greenwich. Greenwich tries another one. Again, the front of the rim. Rebounded by Eiffel. Eiffel looking for someone. It says, you know, he waves off Maynard. I'll bring up the ball. Eiffel. Directing traffic. Gives it up to Gibbons. Gibbons marked by Thorne. Trying to get past. Can't get past. But he still has the dribble. He drives. Nothing. Gives it up to Manuel Aleng. Who gets it in the post to Andrew Eiffel. And Eiffel! Doesn't get the foul, but he gets the basket.
Yes, and that was a big one on the inside. And now
it is now the halftime. That's the end of the third quarter.
Yes.
And the Bulls, as a familiar number, they're up by 20, 56 to 36. So, Terry, let's reset. We now have one more quarter to go, 10 playing minutes. Celtics are still down by 20. What can you tell them?
Let's prepare for game three.
that seems to be okay, but what can you do? You need to still have some momentum.
Yeah, we want some momentum going into the third game. So what I would basically tell them right now is let us try to make it a game. Try to get it by the 5 minutes to go, be down 10, right? And you only can get that by playing good D. What has happened?
The 15 rebounds and the two big men from the Bulls had 14 together.
Correct.
So clearly he's a good rebounder. Now we have the start of the fourth quarter. 10 more minutes here in game number two of the BABF final series. The Celtics lead the series 1-0. The Bulls trying to even it up 1-1 to send it into game number three on Thursday. Now we have Hunt. We have the ball on the inside. He should have made it two and a foul, but he will go to the free throw line.
Yes, and they continue to put the ball inside. They're very, very patient. The only problem with patience when you're down 20 is that you have to really speed it up. You can't trade baskets and you can't let the time go on because time is not on your side, nor is the score. So you have to speed it a little. But they've been very patient. They go inside to Hunt and he has delivered.
Okay, well, and Hunt goes to the line. He misses the first free throw there. So he's now 3 of 5 from the charity line. Still having a good game, 17 points. Really coming on here in the second half. Theo Greenwich, he has 10, but he's shooting 3 of 10. So not a percentage that he would like at all coming into this game. You know, he had a really good regular season.
Yes. But, you know what they say about you know, regular seasons?
Mm-hmm.
That's why they call it regular.
They come to an end. Bulls with the ball, still trying to get the ball into Marsh on the inside. He's now being marked by Hunt. Hunt not doing a good job. Marsh gets on the inside and actually... I think Hunt did not do as good a job as King. King was actually doing a pretty good job on him. They switch and Marsh with two easy points down low.
Yes, Marsh is now really going to work. And I think Morris is really going to work now.
And we have a fall, three players around. Let's see who it will be called upon. That's fall on number 23. So that is Eiffel. Eiffel with the foul. And, he's going to come and question the referee. That's his third foul. This is a game that I guess he could afford to have three fouls, but clearly he's still talking to the referee. I had the ball.
You know, what he's saying is that he wasn't out of shooting. So he should get the ball from his side.
From the side rather than shooting free throws.
Right. So he didn't complain about the foul. What he's saying is that, but there's something called in basketball called gather. So once you get in that motion, your intent is to shoot.
Right. So therefore, of course, talking to the referee, if the referee has that bit of an opportunity, they might just educate him to that.
Yes. well, you know, sometimes the game is get to a point where education would have to be at halftime or
at the end of the game. Come and talk to me after the game.
Yeah, yeah.
So still the ball stays with the Celtics. Ball out of bounds. And we now have Thorne with the ball. Passes it up to Greenidge. Greenidge back to Thorne. Thorne looking to get it on the inside. They're looking so much for Joel Hunt right now, but he's being double teamed. And we have the three from the outside, missed and corralled by Akeem Marsh. Marsh with the ball. Gives it up now to Simeon Maynard, who brings it up slowly. As the Bulls will be bringing it up slowly, time is definitely on their side. 9 minutes to go. They're up big. No need to rush. Gibbons with the ball. He's being marked closely, but he's looking for Marsh. Didn't find him, so he swung around to Maynard. Maynard, still with the handles, behind the back. Looking all nice and fancy, and blocked by Joel Hunt. Hunt doing everything for the Celtics. Hunt, now he has the ball stolen, and now easy 2 points, as you like. And Marsh with abuses the rim.
Another down.
I know, Celtics with the ball. We're up and down. And Marsh, first with the block. Sorry, first of the dunk, now the block.
Yes, Marsh has really put his imprint in this game. I don't think you could ask for anything more from a man over 35.
and I think after the type of game he had in game one, he owed the Bulls fans. So this is he's paying back.
Yes,
his deficit.
I think he was. He owed them lunch and dinner and all sorts of other things.
Or at least a better game, too.
Yeah.
And we now have a timeout being called by the Celtics. Celtics calling a timeout. They're down 60 to 37. Clearly, although they're down so big with 8 minutes to go, clearly hope is still on their side.
Yes, unless it's Bob Hope. or Shea Hope. Uh-huh. But I think the Bulls will have to implode for this to for them to lose it from here. However, basketball is one of those games that people can implode.
And even if they implode with 8.5 minutes to go, at what point do they implement trying to shoot the three? Or do you think that they have tried to shoot so many threes and failed that they've abandoned that strategy of shooting the threes?
Or traditionally, though, if you look back at his stats, The Celtics is a poor three-point shooting team. What they do, they go from volume. So they take many, so they only shoot it at 25%. Bulls probably is the best three-point shooting team, right, in the competition. But Celtics is not a good three-point shooting team.
And what I can tell you, they've shot 1 of 24 as a team from the three-point line in this game. And here's another one, and Hunt finally gets on the scorecard, so they're now 2 of 25 from the three-point line, and Thorne with his first three of the game with 8 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
Let's see if this is the catalyst for the Celtics to really start to do something.
And the Bulls now with the ball. Inside now to Marsh. Marsh gets it, but I think he is arguing it's in the foul. Is there a foul or just jump ball?
Yeah, jump ball, and the ball is with
possession
the Celtics.
Arrow is staying though with the Bulls. Possession arrow with the Bulls.
Oh, okay. The ball is with the Bulls. I thought they got the last one, but...
So maybe it wasn't. Maybe it was not jump ball.
Oh, okay, maybe.
Yeah, maybe it wasn't jump ball. But still, the Bulls with the ball. We'll see what they can get the ball in to Eiffel. Eiffel then throws it out to Alang. Alang gives it to Maynard. Back to Alang. Eiffel. He drives the baseline. Finds Gibbons. Gibbons with the outside jumper. Misses, rebounded by Hunt. Celtics now. Bringing up the ball. King. He may let the drive. Swings it over. A 9 Thorne going for 2 for 2. He misses that one. Rebounded by Alang.
Yes, Alain is back in the game and he's doing his thing. And his thing is do the other things that the other players don't do.
Utility player.
Yes.
Maynard with the ball, showing the handles. This time the easy lip, he misses. Maynard not having a good game. Hunt with the rebound, he brings it. Will he go coast to coast? I think he will. Shooting, missing though, rebounded by Alain. And it leads to an easy fast break for the Bulls. That is Maynard with the finger roll. And Celtics now really shooting themselves in the foot.
Yeah, well, I think Celtics will really try to see if they can make this a game. Not only make it a game, but also to get some momentum going into the third game. You don't want to go into the third game being beaten, you know, crestfallen. You know, you want to have some sort of momentum going into that game.
Indeed, because you don't want people to start thinking that game one was a fluke. And in my mind, it wasn't. But still, this is not a good showing in game number two.
Yeah, they may be missing their coach. And that's another three.
Another three. And that's this one, Theo Greenidge with a three. So they're now looking to get some threes in there. And as I was saying to you, at some point, if they really want to cut into this deficit, they got to start hitting the threes.
Yes, and they're taking the threes too.
There you go. Take them and make them. Marsh now with the ball at the top of the key. Being marked by Hunt. That's not where we want Marsh at all. Eiffel, he drives. Will he go for the layup? He does, but he's blocked by Greenidge. King now bringing up the ball for the Celtics. Greenidge, he's going to take on the big man, and he gets the foul. Well, he gets the point, but he was calling for the foul. No foul, though.
Yes, and that is 19 or 17.
Yep.
So we'll see what happens here now with the Bulls. Bulls now into slow motion mode.
Slow motion mode with only 6 minutes to go. They're trying to run seconds off the clock. Maynard showing the handles. Finally, the ball gets into the big man Marsh, but as soon as he puts it beneath his waist, the hands are there trying to steal it. Oh, and Joel Hunt trying to feed King, but miscommunication. King was on the highway to the basket looking to just go straight to the hole, but pass behind him, and it's a turnover.
Well, if I was in Joel Hunt's position, there's no way it was passing out to King. They would have to foul me or just let me go through the hole.
Yeah. Well, maybe he's trying to get his other players to play because he can't win it on his own.
Yeah, well, that's true too.
Alain now with the ball. I am certain he threw that up for Ben to go fetch it. But I don't think Ben realized it. And that was a big miss there by Renico Brewster. He was all alone, missed it. Brewster not having a good night at all. He's usually a shooter. Brewster not having a good night. He's 1 for 9 for the game. Bulls now getting back the ball. I really don't think that Celtics are really not trying to win this one. Or maybe the other way around, they're trying too hard.
Well, it's under 5 minutes to go and they're down, what, 17? Let's see what happens here.
Maynard still showing the handles. Gives it up to Gibbons. I think that one is a bit too hard, but still rebounded by Gibbons. Gibbons gets his own rebound. Oh, lovely
spin move.
That was
a lovely spin move by Gibbons.
Didn't get it to drop, but he got the foul and he's going to the charity line.
Yes, one of the veterans from, and I'm really, you know, it really shocks me to say that Raheem Gibbons is a veteran, but he has been playing with the Bulls from a junior, and he's now the captain, and he does his thing. And that was a really nice move. He should really finish it with two free throws. Let's see what happens. He's not a bad free throw shooter, so we'll see what happens.
Raheem Gibbons, we've been hearing about him even in the school days when he was running the point for Harrison College.
Yes.
And really dominating when he was a schoolboy. Raheem Gibbons in this game now, he has 12 points. As far as the free throws, he's actually going to the line for the first time for the night.
Okay, well, jump shooters don't really get fouled.
So
but he is really now decided Marsh is out of the game. I got to do something else. So he decided that he will take it to the hole.
Misses the first free throw. Obviously disappointed. I wonder about Gibbons. Like his father, he doesn't like to miss.
Yeah.
Does not like to miss.
I have not seen a shot that he didn't like, but he's a good shooter.
Very good shooter. And he's not even, in my mind, he's not shooting as good as he used to.
Yes.
And now Joseph Thorne with the ball for the Celtics. He made a three earlier, but missed his last shot. What will he do this time? Gives it up to Greenidge. Gibbons swings it out to King. King gives it over to Brewster. Brewster to Hunt. Gives it to Thorne. Will Thorne try again? He drives and he gets the runner.
Yes, a good runner there from Joseph Thorne.
Thorne there with the runner. And we have now Bulls on the offense. Give it to Gibbons. And as we realize that Marsh has been subbed, Marsh is on the bench. So we'll see if the other big man, Kemar Benn, will get the ball on the inside. I could have called traveling for that one. I actually think the referee was a bit late on that one.
Yes, I think anybody in the building could have called traveling.
But eventually it was called.
Yes.
Ball back this way now for the Celtics. Going for the steal there with the Bulls. Celtics still trying. Joseph Anthorn going for the shot. Missed it. Rebounded by Hunt. But he's lost the ball and is now going again for the Bulls. Maynard showing the handles all game long. Not good shot selection, but showing very good save handles. He's dribbling. Looking for the pick and roll with Benn. Gives it up though for the open shot. Will Gibbons get it? He misses, but there's a foul on the shooter.
Yes.
Brewster fouling the shooter, and will it be a three? Was he foul shooting the three or foul shooting the two?
Yes,
foul shooting the three.
Yes, and we just said that
shooters are not fouled.
Shooters don't usually get a foul. But I think we had to call Brewster one of the previous round.
Well, mission not accomplished. And we're having a sub. So I think we're going to have Raheem Gibbons at the free throw line. As the teams talk it over, he'll be at the line shooting three. Let's see how he does the first. From the free throw line, he's 1 for 2 for the night. And he misses that as well. So he's now 1 for 3 from the free throw line for the night.
Yeah, I think he will be shooting a lot of free throws at practice tomorrow.
Yep. Just one off there between games 2 and 3. Game 3 on Thursday. We'll be back. Live coverage.
Yes, and we're hoping it will be 1-1. We think it will be 1-1.
We think it will be 1-1, yeah, indeed. Yeah. And that's Gibbons getting the second. He has another.
Yes.
Foul shooting the three, so he gets 3 free throws. Renico Watson, the referee, calls for the ball. And Celtics now decided, okay, yeah, we need to get some rebounders in there. Gibbons, couple dribbles. Spinning off the ball. Ball up and in. So 2 of 3 from the lane on that attempt. So not a bad at all. And the Celtics now subbing 3 players and actually bringing in even players off the bench that did not play at all. So is this the case that they're throwing in the towel? Because Covington is coming in.
Well, I think the towel is well and truly in.
Yes, I think it is.
I think Bulls had decided that they have won this game because Marshall's on the bench for a little bit now.
Yes, and subbed for the Celtics, and Anand Thorne is out, and he's already pulled his shirt out of his pants. So I think he doesn't think that he's going back in with 3:17 to go as the Celtics score. Also, Theo Greenidge is subbed. So when you sub Greenidge and you sub Thorne, I think, yeah, they're saying, yeah, throw in the towel, get you guys some rest, come back nice and fresh for Thursday. But the Bulls with the ball, Maynard, he has played a lot this game, and he's still on the court, showing the dribble behind the back, between the legs, showing us everything. Showing us the whole repertoire. 3 shots to go on the shot clock. And he's fouled. He has lost the ball. And he's fouled driving to the hole.
Yes, that was not a smart foul at all. And don't complain that it wasn't a foul. Because even if you didn't hit the mere fact that you swipe at the basketball. Right? I mean, with 3 seconds to go with the man that off balance. I don't think that was a smart foul at all.
And, you know, just looking up into the stands, Elk, I can see some spectators that should be heading towards the exit.
Yes. When we played in the YMCA, Harry Garnes was called this time, the folks are leaving. Right? This is this time. The folks are leaving. When Harry Garnes said that the folks are leaving, it means that we're done with the game.
Finished with the game. Home. There you go. Harry Garnes, a former national player back in the day. Eiffel with the ball, gets the rebound, gives it up to Rock. Rock with the jumper. He misses. I think another scene for this time is garbage time.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't let you say it's garbage time, but yes.
But it is a scene.
Yeah, it is a scene.
Yes.
And I think it's time that we're ready to go home. I think Bulls, this group that is on the court, Bulls will not have, if the game was close, I don't think this group would be on the court.
Indeed not. And we have Raheem Gibbons with the ball. He's marked by Brewster. Brewster focused on the ball, still playing some good defense. They're now playing a tight man-to-man defense. And Bulls have spread the court, letting the shot clock go down. Gibbons looking for that shot, misses. But the rebound is with Rock. Rock now going up, thought he had been fouled. He hasn't been fouled. And yet again, Bulls with the rebound. Rock gives it up to Eiffel. 3 seconds to shoot. Gibbons lets one fly, at least it hits the ring, but rebounded by King of the Celtics. Celtics bringing it up. Showing some urgency with 1:45 to go.
I think everybody's just waiting for the final whistle.
Including
the Celtics.
Oh, yes. Oh, alley-oop. But the Bulls almost had the fancy alley-oop. But instead, they get the steal. And Raheem Gibbons forces in with the left-hand layup. That's two more to him. The Bulls now leading by a big, that almost will be 67-49, with 1:16 to go. And, yeah, this is definitely no garbage time. Everyone is shooting. No defense is being played. A former colleague of mine, Doug Hoyt, would say, strike up the band.
Yeah, we're about to go home. Yeah, we're ready to go home.
And shot by the Bulls.
That's Gibbs.
That is in and out.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Definitely no. This is anybody's time.
Yeah, 1 minute, under a minute to go, and it is, what, 18? I think it's all over. Brewster is now going to try to strike something.
Yep.
The ball is with the Bulls. This is Andrew Eiffel. He played a very good game. So did Raheem Gibbons.
Indeed.
Right? And big Akeem Marsh had a lot of time on the bench.
Indeed. Akeem Marsh had 20 points of 9 of 12 shooting. Good game for the big man. As far as rebounds are concerned, he also had 9 points, or one rebound away from a double-double. And this one is icing on the cake. That sums up the game. Another steal by Raheem Gibbons. And waltzes in. That really sums up the game for you.
Yes. So it is 20-point win for the Bulls. A real bounce back from being defeated at BCC.
At BCC, indeed. And there's the final whistle. The Bulls with a 20-point victory, 69-49, to level the series at 1-1. Looking at the score sheets, Akeem Marsh with 20 points and 9 rebounds, just missing out on a double-double. And Raheem Gibbons, he had 17 points to be the second top scorer for the Bulls. Looking at the Celtics, we had Joel Hunt with 18 points and 10 rebounds. He had a double-double. Theo Greenidge, he had 15 points, but that's all she wrote. Bulls 1-1, and we have again number 3. We have a series.
Yes. As I said, Bulls was in this same position last time
against the Pinelands.
Yes. And what they did was they won games 2 and 3, and Pinelands won 4 and 5. I'm not sure what's going to happen next, but I must tell you that I found that Bulls play better in the gym, and they don't play as good in BCC. Mm-hmm. And it may be a couple of things. In BCC, it's really hot.
them because in the last game we got up 26-83. We were getting good shots.
Yeah.
We were just not making the shots.
Okay.
I thought defensively we had to make the adjustment. You know, obviously their aim is to pull our big men away from the basket. So I had to come up with something to keep them close to the basket and try to contain Joel, who always been a turn our side for the longest time.
Yeah.
So we're able to do it tonight. So we'll see, it's a chess game. So you'll see what can they employ now to combat that.
Yeah, well, I would hope that I would like to know that they will make adjustments. I noticed they made adjustments in the second half because Joel was not a factor in the first half.
Yes.
And then he was a factor in the second half. He had the ball getting in on the, he got the ball on the inside regularly.
Yeah.
Right? And I would expect that you would look at a post-mortem.
Of course.
And you will see that he will not stop him from getting the ball in the middle. But my thing is, what do you think, what was your mindset coming into this game, actually? When I say mindset, I know you want to win.
Yeah.
But you scored what?
69
yeah.
points?
That's not a Bulls score.
No.
Bulls is used to score 80, 90. So tell me, just break it down for me. What was your mindset
the
coming
key
in?
Is, for us, I think, controlling the tempo, which means in this case, we want to go a little slower because our team is in deep. You know, we have a short bench, so which means our starters will be logging lots of minutes. Hence, we know we can't get track meets.
Yeah, yeah.
We can struggle in the end sometimes.
Right.
And you will find that that's why you miss a lot of shots in the bottom because you're so tired, your legs are tired.
Yeah.
So the aim here now, you have to control the pace of the game. We have a very good ball handler to turn the guards. So we can, when needed, we can speed up. But in this situation, we have to control that pace, slow it down, and force them to defend every possession and try to get a ball on the interior for them, obviously, to defend the guys on the inside.
Okay. Well, congratulations.
Thanks.
And I wish you the best in going in third game.
Yes, I wish myself the best as well, too.